here today with Pauline de Burge, and we're discussing slow fashion, and we're in his workshop, and I wanted to talk about this piece.
This piece?
Yeah.
Is for plus size, which is awesome, because I don't discriminate. I think all people are beautiful, and I want to dress everybody if I can. But originally, this piece was just a pleated skirt, my full skirt that came in, so it would have sat from here down to the floor, but because it's such a nice colour and it's got pleating, which I'm always a big fan of, I wanted to just restyle it into a dress. So I lifted it up, added on some straps, and kind of got it bigger towards the back, and yeah, they have this part that's not pleated up the top.
And this is
really nice.
You can come closer. This is what I wanted to show, which I noticed as soon as I saw this dress, is this little piece in here. And when you're looking at fast fashion, for production efficiency, normally the pleating would come straight under the bodice. And what that does, it then sticks out and actually makes your hips look bigger than what they are. Mm. And Paul's put it in this little piece here, so it drops the pleating down to sit on the hip, right on the, rather than coming from up here. And because you want to look like you've just taken this in for me. And if it can be really boxy if it comes from up here.
Yeah,
it makes you look bigger than what you are. And when I saw this detailing, I thought, that's a man who really knows women's figures and really knows clothes, because it's just such a considered approach, and you'd never see that in off the rack stuff.
Yeah.
And the other thing I really liked about this, for someone who is bigger, having the broader straps rather than the string straps, because if you've got little string straps and you're a bigger woman, it can make you look enormous in comparison to the straps.
Mm.
And so these actually really balance it out, having the broader strap.
Yeah, which is definitely something that I did take into consideration. Yeah, I think it's quite often, a lot of times, I take it for granted what I do actually do, because it just naturally
comes
just,
to you.
Yeah, and it's like, oh, I need to just be so big, and it'd be just nice to just do this. And I know, like, having things on a mannequin, you can just kind of play with the proportions a bit more to make it work.
Yeah, but this is really, for someone who is bigger, this is really, really flattering.
Mm.
And when I saw this, it really made me, it made me really think that these are the considerations that are never taken into account in that mass production. It's just design the piece and then scale it from size 6 or whatever the American size, you know, New Zealand size 6 through to size 18. And there's no consideration for the dimensions on the body.
Yeah, definitely. And I think it's all, and I think, like, if, say, a lot of the times things get sampled in a size like New Zealand 6 or whatever, when it gets up to the larger sizes, it's lost and it's not actually translating well, especially for like bust sizes and like the shape and curves of like real women.
Yeah. Yeah, and most women in New Zealand aren't a size 10 or a size 12 anymore. I think we're, sent the majority, 14 and might even be slightly larger.
Mm.
But yeah, our starting point for the majority of New Zealanders is a size 14, not a size 10. So this is, I'd love to see it on someone.
Yeah,
I think it would look really great.
To get it on, because like sometimes, I just need to try them on people.
Get the body in it.
Yeah. And then I can, you know, keep on like taking on board like what people's needs and wants are. And like fulfilling that void for people, where like they'll go into a shop and then feel bad about themselves because the things aren't fitting. which is good for, I mean, plastic is not in season.
No.
And reusable bags are. But these were done from like old pants, and it's really good. Like, the thing about upcycling, which I really like, is sometimes a lot of practical work's already done for you. So, you know, there's handy pockets to put your shopping list in, and like your keys and everything.
I didn't think about that. Yeah. Cell phone.
Yeah, cell phone, so you don't have to lose all of your stuff. But, because these pants, they were like kind of like worn at the knees.
Right.
So then it's either mend that or just redo onto something else. And like, I like the practical aspect of what these bags can do.
And I like the little.
Yeah.
The waistband on it, how cute is that? Something you take. Well, you actually wouldn't ever see that if you're wearing it.
No.
But it looks cute.
Yeah. That kind of like classic.
So that was a skirt?
These were trousers as well. Just and I just like re-edit the button back on there. So it's nice to just kind of like do 100% upcycle.
Yeah, taking pieces from that garment.
Yeah. And then there's these ones as well, which are quite cool. These are jewels, but like the scarves are good because then you can tie it and adjust it to whatever length you need. And scarves are always quite nice, so it's not going to cut into you if you've like, loaded up your shopping bag as well.
Yeah. Very good. I thought they were little bananas, but no.
They're light.
What are they?
Lighters.
Oh, really?
Yeah. These were some.
The smoker's pants.
Yeah.
Cute. Very cute colours for summer. And this one
was made from one of my t-shirts that I can no longer fit, but that's cool.
Happens to the best of us.
Yeah, but I always loved this t-shirt, so I've always held on to it, and like, I thought it was just time to turn it into something else, and I think it's just worked like really well. Nice lightning on the back. Yeah, and then using some trouser waistbanding on the inside just to kind of give it strength for the handles.
Yeah, it gives it structure, doesn't it?
Yeah. So then like, once it's got like a bit of weight in it, it's gonna like hold it.
Yeah. That is
Sounds
very cool.
Yeah.
We'll see that down the beach.
Oh yeah, totally.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, and one piece, which is, I can't wear white that much because I get stains on things. I had this t-shirt which I've always loved, but I love sushi t-shirt, which is such a cool print, and so I repurposed that into something that I can kind of like keep and pass down. So I used like a t-shirt on the front there, and then an old men's shirt on the back, so it's got the buttons to put the cushion.
Brilliant. Yeah.
So it's just nice finding like two pieces and combining them to make it like work.
And then you haven't lost your favourite t-shirt.
Yeah, no. And I've got it out of the wardrobe again, which is really nice, instead of it just sitting in the wardrobe collecting dust, and I'm just always going, Am I gonna wear it?
And the other thing that would be great for is, you know, when t-shirts go around the neck as well, but you love the print. That would be great.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. And I've done like a couple of pieces for people that have like loved ones that have passed on and have made cushions out of clothing that they had, so it's something that they can pass on to generation. And it's just really nice for like those pieces that are just sitting in the wardrobe can come out, go into the home and can tell a story, and then can also be passed on to generations. So yeah, like I feel really special to have done pieces like people?
Rather than having, like, if you imagine someone that you love and you're not necessarily going to have an outfit or a dress that they wore hanging out there, because that's kind of a bit weird, unusual.
Yeah, yeah.
But having a piece of fabric that you remember them for, and of course, that's really lovely.
Yeah, and it's so nice for, like, even like furnishing pieces in the home to have a story instead of like going to chainsaws and getting things that are just soulless,
yeah.
You know? Like, I think that's what's awesome about slow fashion is that you can add soul back in to pieces.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. Yeah, I love what you're saying about that emotional connection through clothing. And if I think about it, I think about my grandmother, and I can still, I think of her in terms of the colours that she wore.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
The prints that she wore, and that has a real connect in my mind. And I hadn't thought about it before, about taking someone who's passed, taking a piece of their clothing and making something that you keep that reminds you of them. It's really beautiful.
Oh, thanks. And then it can be passed on as well, which is cool.
Yeah, and that's kind of soul connection to the clothes that you wear. So they're on your body, and they become almost an integral part of yourself.
Mm.
So the retaining some of that for someone that has passed is really, I think it's really lovely.
Oh, yeah. That's cool, like, yeah, like the piece that I did do for my friend, it was just really nice to know that the piece that was in the wardrobe has come out and it's back in the home and has a story, and she can say, like, how it was used when people ask, like, oh, that's a cool question. And it's like, oh, you know, it used to be, like, my mother's gardening top.
Lovely. Well, it just makes you
want
to hold on to it.
Yeah. And then she did take it. She was like holding, like hugging it, and just like so stoked. And it was just, yeah, it was just so nice to like add soul back into the garments. And that's such a beautiful thing about slow fashion, is there are connections with a lot of these textiles that we have, and we can just make it something meaningful.
I mean, don't have to lose that connection.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The integrity is still there, the story is still all there, and it can just be passed on to generation to generation. Like, why buy a soulless cushion when you can get a custom one done from fabrics that are sitting in the wardrobe from your loved ones?
Yeah, beautiful. Really beautiful. If you want to check out Paul's work, it's Edgar and Bird. On all the normal platforms,
yep.
Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, Edgar and Bird. Come and check them out.